Are you ready, world? Here's a sneak peek at MetLife Stadium, the home of WrestleMania.
I'm back where I belong. Yeah, I never felt so strong. Yeah. I'm back.
It's the Statue of Liberty.
And if you will be, put your hands high.
There you are. It's the Brooklyn Bridge. It's the Empire State Building.
Feel so good.
80,000 strong will pack MetLife Stadium for WrestleMania. How about those apples, huh?
And now, the WrestleMania pre-show.
The doors have opened. The WWE Universe has started to file inside MetLife Stadium in the heart of New York and New Jersey. Mr. McMahon revealed the sights earlier this week via Twitter, but this is your first live look at WrestleMania. In less than 60 minutes, nearly 80,000 will jam-pack this stadium as we welcome you to the live, hour-long WrestleMania pre-show.
And we are starting big tonight because the gritty, unrelenting Intercontinental Champion, the bare-knuckled Brit Wade Barrett, will defend his title against one of the most charismatic and captivating superstars in WWE's history, The Miz.
Good evening, everyone. Josh Matthews ringside with Matt Stryker. Matt, we are live on the WWE app, YouTube, Facebook, Yahoo, and of course, WWE.com. More ways than ever to be a part of the live WrestleMania pre-show and, of course, WrestleMania.
WrestleMania will be a night to remember for everyone. Contact your pay-per-view provider if you want to be a part of history. Because tonight, for the first time ever, WrestleMania is available through your Xbox Live, as well as your Samsung Smart TVs, easy for me to say, along with WWE.com and the WWE app as well. Wherever you are watching around the world, we want to welcome you into our home, the four-hour spectacular that is WrestleMania.
Of course, WrestleMania gets started 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. It will be the most interactive WrestleMania of all time. We encourage all of you, members of the WWE Universe, to tout us your favorite WrestleMania moment of all time using the hashtag ManiaMoment, and you may see those touts later right here live on the WrestleMania pre-show. Are you touting right now?
No, I'm actually on Facebook voting for which match is going to steal the show tonight. There's my vote.
So everyone's certainly busy, including our broadcast colleague, Scott Stanford, who's live inside MetLife Stadium. Scott?
All right, Josh, all eyes of the WWE Universe focused right here on MetLife Stadium, WrestleMania. And what an honor it is for me to be joined by this esteemed panel. We've got two members of the Hall of Fame class of 2007. Good old JR Jim Ross, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, and the High Flyer Kofi Kingston. Fellas, what an amazing night we have tonight. And JR, I want to start with you. You've been to so many WrestleManias. This has to be the most anticipated WrestleMania of all time.
Well, I'll tell you what, Scott, I started at WrestleMania 20 years ago at WrestleMania 9. I'm just as excited about tonight as I was then. It's going to be a phenomenal night with a great crowd. They're going to give us their all. It's going to be a night we'll never forget.
And Kofi Kingston, this place, not even half full, it's about to erupt.
It is about to erupt. I think a big part of it is the fact that this, the New York, New Jersey area, this is the foundations of the WWE. WWE was built right here. So right now we got WrestleMania coming back. It's all about full circle.
Well, let me tell you something about WrestleMania. Let me tell you something about the WWE fulfilling dreams throughout the world tonight, that we will entertain this whole world. But there are issues to be solved. There are careers on the line. There are streets are running rampant here in MetLife Stadium. It's going to be something big.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, pandemonium set to run wild here at MetLife Stadium. So many unbelievable matches. Triple H, Brock Lesnar, The Rock, John Cena, and don't forget, the World Heavyweight Championship is on the line tonight. It is going to be unbelievable. Alberto Del Rio defending the title against Jack Swagger. Tell you what, Zeb Coulter has Swagger more confident than ever, but Alberto is out to prove that this is his United States of America.
Fellow Americans, I got a question for you. What is wrong with America?
I see people with faces not like mine.
People crossing our borders illegally
across our borders.
And they take our jobs,
our resources.
Let's forget all the politically correct
crap. How do we get rid of them?
America was built as the land of opportunity, where decent, law-abiding, respectful citizens could provide a better way of life for their families. Somewhere along the way, that land of opportunity has turned into a desert of despair, because if our government won't do anything to help us, I know someone who will.
Swagger did it! Jack Swagger is going to WrestleMania!
We will not stand idly by and watch this country self-destruct. Jack Swagger is gonna capture the World Heavyweight title, and he's gonna reclaim America. We the people!
A mighty woman with a torch. And her name, Mother of Exiles. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. In America, everything is possible. And this man, Alberto Del Rio, he's a living proof of that.
Alberto!
We got a new World Heavyweight Champion! Unbelievable! Unbelievable!
I'm Alberto Del Rio, and I was born in Mexico, but made in America.
Alberto Del Rio is not one of us. A man who only came into this country to reap the rewards of our motherland. He needs to leave this country.
We are here for the same reason. We want to provide our families with a better life.
You're part of the problem, and we the people are gonna fix the problem. Welcome to Jack Swagger's America!
We're coming!
We the people!
Well, I'll tell you what, it's certainly very clear that both Jack Swagger and Alberto Del Rio love this country, JR. Now, you've known Jack Swagger for a very long time. Have you seen this man more determined, more focused than ever than he is right now?
Well, Jack Swagger is not the same athlete that I met at the University of Oklahoma. He is very focused right now. He's under the psychological influence, in my opinion, of Zeb Coulter. Bottom line for me is that Alberto Del Rio's got to wrestle the most physical, intense match of his life to retain the heavyweight title tonight, Kofi.
You talked about Jack Swagger being very focused. I think Del Rio is also very focused. I've never seen him this angry. I mean, he got his back blasted wide open by Jack Swagger in that crutch. I mean, he's had his best friend's ankle broken. I'm telling you right now, Alberto Del Rio is definitely, definitely fired up.
Let me tell you something about Alberto Del Rio. He made a great point. when you think about the boundaries and you think about Ellis Island and you think about the Statue of Liberty and you think about achieving that America dream, no place is better than right here tonight to reach out and grab a hold of that American dream and prove to the world, Alberto Del Rio, that you are the better man. And I'm gonna pick him to do that thing tonight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, WrestleMania started here in the New York, New Jersey area. It's very first one. This is the home, and tonight we are coming home.
I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming.
I'm back where I belong. Yeah, I never felt so strong. Hey, I'm back. I'm feeling like there's nothing I can't try. And if you with me, put your hands high.
Put your hands, no stopping us now. I love that song. Whenever it comes on, it makes me feel strong. I thought I told you that we won't stop till we back cruising through Harlem. These old blocks is what made me, saved me, drove me crazy, drove me away, then embraced me, forgave me for all of my shortcomings. Welcome to my homecoming. Yeah, thank you.
We now sit under 48 minutes away from WrestleMania as the WWE Universe continues to file into MetLife Stadium. Earlier, we asked all of you to tout your favorite WrestleMania moment of all time. Keep those touts coming. Use the hashtag ManiaMoment. You may see your tout right here live on the WrestleMania pre-show.
Yeah, but you have to hurry because WrestleMania explodes at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. Right now, we are streaming live on Facebook, Yahoo, as well as WWE Active. Listen to this crowd. They are electric. Do what you have to do to join us on this special evening.
And of course, imagine watching WrestleMania on your tablet or smartphone. Hey, everyone grab your cellular devices right now. This is your opportunity to win two tickets to next year's WrestleMania, WrestleMania 30. All you have to do is text Mania 30, that's M-A-N-I-A 30, to 59907. You may be texting your way to next year's WrestleMania. And the harsh reality of it is, next year's WrestleMania, Matt, may not feature Triple H. Should the game lose to Brock Lesnar tonight, it's no holds barred with Triple H's career on the line.
Triple H fights for family and honor, but in a no holds barred situation with the perversely sadistic Brock Lesnar, the question is, will Triple H's legendary career come to an abrupt end tonight?
It all started when Triple H was simply looking for one thing: to reignite the flame.
Last time I stood in this ring with a microphone in my hands, it was 8 days after SummerSlam. 8 days after getting beaten by Brock Lesnar, 8 days after he broke my arm for the second time in 2 months. I stood in this ring, I thought I might be done. And the thing was, the second that cast was off, I was back in the gym. And I was just waiting. Waiting for a reason. Then I found myself sitting next to a hospital bed, looking at an old man who had just got done having hip surgery. Put aside the fact that his daughter, my wife, my kids sat crying at that bedside. I sat there with a smile inside because I'd just found my reason.
The game! Triple H, and the fight is on! Triple H and Lesnar!
Brock Lesnar, the ass kicker, the game is back, and he's calling you out for WrestleMania!
Triple H, the demon inside him has been released!
So what's it gonna be, Brock? Are you gonna show up at WrestleMania? Are you gonna show up and fight? Or are you just gonna sit there and bleed?
if and only if you sign this agreement to fight Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania, then I will tell you the stipulations we picked for you.
If he wants to make Lesnar pay for all his sins, breaking Triple H's arm twice, breaking the arm of his best friend Shawn Michaels, putting his father-in-law, Mr. McMahon, in the hospital with hip replacement surgery, Triple H has to take this match, sign the contract, no matter what.
Being the visionary that I am, at WrestleMania, it's Brock Lesnar versus The Game. And Triple H is blindfolded! With your hands, ankles, shackled! I want to make it really personal between the two of you. At WrestleMania, the winner of the match gets your wife, Stephanie. But since we're talking personally, we all know that wouldn't work, because wouldn't it be more fitting if the loser gets Stephanie?
Heyman pushed the line.
Go call your monster.
And here comes Lesnar.
Your match will be no countout, no disqualification, no holds barred. Oh, yeah. Your career is on the line!
Well, my friends, you certainly don't have to be a psychologist to see that Triple H has absolute revenge on his mind. Dusty Rhodes, I want to pose this question to you. Brock Lesnar is an absolute beast. Can The Game put a stop to Lesnar? And if he doesn't, is Triple H prepared to walk away?
We talked a lot about entertainment. We talked about worldwide entertainment going throughout the universe, if you will. This here is nothing more than a fight. It's a fight picked by a man, and we're going to have to see who comes out at the end. No disqualification, no count out. Anything goes. Careers on the line. I've been in this situation. I understand what's going down here. Kofi,
yes,
this is going to be a mess.
It's going to be a mess indeed. It's very, very personal. We all just saw the highlight tape. We saw what Brock Lesnar has done to Vince McMahon. We saw Brock Lesnar break Triple H's arm last time they got involved. Now it's no holds barred. I don't know, man. I don't know.
Well, I know that this is what I know. I know that Dr. Heymanstein has a genetic monster that he is advising by the name of Brock Lesnar. Lesnar's the last man you want to get into your perhaps last fight with. This is going to be a long night, I think, for the cerebral assassin.
Dr. Heymanstein, I like that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, what an amazing WrestleMania week this has been. Of course, it culminates tonight here at MetLife. But I'll tell you what, the WWE Universe has been hanging out outside the stadium doing a little tailgating. Let's send it out to Tony Dawson hanging with the fans.
There is nothing on earth like the passion of the WWE Universe. WWE fans have come from all over the globe. 3 dozen countries, all 50 states represented, and they have been tailgating outside MetLife Stadium, ready to file in 80,000 strong for this, the greatest live event in entertainment. Take a look at Tony here, who's been to every WrestleMania. Tony, are you ready?
I'm ready. I got the championships. We're ready to do it. WrestleMania, MetLife Stadium.
The greatest fans in entertainment, WWE fans, are ready for WrestleMania, New York, New Jersey.
Miss Social Media Ambassador. What's up, Snooks? Congratulations on becoming a new MILF.
Oh my God, I love you. Thank you. That means so much to me.
You know, mother, I'd like to friend.
Oh, I thought you meant the other thing. Anyway, I'm tweeting. Do you want me to tweet anything cool, like your awesome speedo?
Or you could tweet
I'll
about my
tweet for you.
Why don't you tweet this? Wade Barrett is the greatest intercontinental champion of all time, and he deserves something far superior than to be stuck here slumming it with two so-called reality TV stars like The Miz and Snooki.
That's actually more than 140 characters.
Snooki, tweet this. Tonight, at WrestleMania, The Miz takes the one thing that makes Wade Barrett relevant. Hashtag the Intercontinental Championship.
You know what, Miz? I've never liked you. And tonight, I'm gonna show you a very different kind of reality.
Really?
Really?
Yes, really.
Don't worry about it. You're the Miz, and your spray tan looks awesome.
Thanks.
Next.
At MetLife Stadium,
WrestleMania.
There you are.
For the first time ever, experience WrestleMania on these digital devices and Xbox Live. Go to WWE.com to learn more.
Closing in on 39 minutes to go until WrestleMania. MetLife Stadium is open. The WWE Universe continues to file in. This is the live WrestleMania pre-show. We still have a championship match. Wade Barrett defending his Intercontinental Championship against The Miz here live on the pre-show. Matt is touting right now. This is Matt's favorite WrestleMania moment.
Are you kidding me? How could it not be? Look at this place!
And we want to hear from all of you. Please keep sending us your touts for your favorite WrestleMania moment. Use the hashtag ManiaMoment.
Listen, however you do it, whether you go through WWE.com, your Xbox Live, your Samsung Smart TV, or through the WWE app. Look, I don't care if you send up smoke signals. Just be here, because tonight there will be moments that you will regret if you miss.
Including the colossal collision between the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, and the human wrecking ball, Ryback. These two have been on a collision course for weeks. It really got intensified, Matt, a couple of weeks ago on Friday Night SmackDown.
That's right. There's a no contact clause. So Mark Henry and Ryback competed in a bench press competition. This is customary at the NFL Combine. The world record for repetitions with 225 pounds on the bar was 51. Mark Henry broke that record at 53. Ryback appeared to be on his way to breaking Mark Henry's record, but Mark Henry would not allow that. The world's strongest man pressing the heavy steel onto Ryback. Imagine the possible injuries Ryback could have sustained here.
And as a result of this, the rivalry continued this past Monday night on Raw.
There's only one thing that's going to happen tonight, and that smile.
Whoa. Ryback! Ryback just used Santino.
I didn't touch him.
It was from Mark Henry.
Oh, no!
And as Ryback said, he didn't physically make contact with the world's strongest man.
Ryback! Technicality of his own.
I didn't touch you, stupid.
It is gonna be earth-shaking.
This time, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry. Now, Mark, you have a match against Ryback tonight. Is there any concern that he could be one of the few people that could match your strength and power?
In that clip you showed, did he match my strength and power? What I saw is him gasping for air and flat on his face, just like he's gonna be tonight.
Now, tonight is WrestleMania. It's the show of shows. I mean, really, anything could...
You're right, it's WrestleMania. Ryback thinks that because this is his first WrestleMania, that it's gonna be the most memorable. Well, he's right, it's gonna be memorable. Because this is the night that he's gonna get in it, into the Hall of Pain.
Well, folks, I'll tell you what. I had a chance to interview Mark Henry and Ryback earlier this weekend at WrestleMania Access, and both of those fellas said that they are coming away with a victory here tonight. Kofi Kingston, you faced Mark Henry. Is there any way to dismantle the world's strongest man?
We're all going to find out. What you have here is two beasts. You have two immovable objects, both faced with the impossible task of moving a mountain, okay? Mark Henry versus Ryback. Today, we are all going to find out exactly who the man is.
Let me tell you something, Kofi. Two of the strongest men in all the world. Bottom line, though, is Mark Henry is a bad man. So, big coming out party, if you will, for Feed Me More. He might get fed more tonight. You know what I'm talking about.
It is a Mastodon matchup. Mark Henry wins tonight. Experience counts.
Tell you what, guys, WrestleMania week started earlier on Thursday afternoon with that press conference at Radio City.
We head towards the greatest event in live entertainment, WrestleMania.
This is a dream come true for me personally, for my family, and fans all over the world. But I remember when we first began WrestleMania 1 in Madison Square Garden. There's nothing like it in the world.
To perform at MetLife Stadium as WWE Champion means so much to me.
Check this out.
Brock Lesnar is going to learn the lesson of a lifetime this Sunday at WrestleMania.
I was talking about how I was going to beat Brock Lesnar.
Like, remember the business stuff that we need to...
Oh, sorry.
The theme of WrestleMania, coming home, it couldn't be more true. My father has grown the WWE to the global entertainment phenomenon that it is today.
All of us are truly excited to be in the center of entertainment.
WrestleMania around the corner, time to electrify.
This Sunday, I certainly predict for all to be entertained.
Well, the WWE Universe filing into MetLife Stadium. 87,000 fans expected to watch WrestleMania here in person, and millions more around the world. And one of the questions on everyone's mind, will The Undertaker extend the streak to 21-0 as he goes up against CM Punk? Punk has tried so hard to get inside the dead man's head, but will it have any effect on the outcome? Will Punk etch his name in the history books yet again and be the one in 20-1?
Extend my heartfelt condolences for your loss at WrestleMania. To Paul Bearer, you will always be perfect. 20-0. But to everybody else, you're going to be 20-1. The only legacy or memory I care about is my own. Trying to do is getting the Undertaker's head.
That is the ultimate act of disrespect.
Oh, yeah! Undertaker!
Paul wants you to know something. That WrestleMania, if you get counted out or disqualified, it's still a loss. This means everything to the Undertaker, and it doesn't mean a damn thing to me. An Undertaker at WrestleMania, you and your perfect record will rest in peace.
Punk, the disrespect that you've shown Paul Bearer
Defeating you is no longer good enough. The streak may come to an end Sunday, but you will never live to talk about it.
Is it Paul Heyman?
Undertaker's coming for my soul, and the only thing I'm concerned about is beating him.
It's over! It's over, Deadman!
I am the one in 20-1. I promise you, every time somebody thinks about WrestleMania, they're gonna think about CM Punk. I am the one in 20.
Well, I'll tell you what, JR, I don't want to steal your word again, but that is going to be some kind of slobber knocker, if you don't mind me using it. Now, I'll tell you what, you know The Undertaker, he ups his game to an entirely new level when it comes to WrestleMania.
Well, there's no doubt in the last year or so, in my opinion, that CM Punk has been the MVP of WWE. CM Punk wants to etch his legacy forever here tonight. It's the voice of the voiceless versus the once the soul of the soulless. But it's not going to happen. 21-0 tonight.
All right, you know, guys. So many superstars have tried, 20 of them to be exact, each thinking that they were the one. Tonight, the WWE Universe will witness history as the Phenom either goes 21-0 or CM Punk becomes the one.
Punk. CM Punk. Warrior. Rock.
Just bring it!
Shop. WWE Shop. For all official WrestleMania gear and merchandise, go to the one and only WWEshop.com.
A tremendous look inside MetLife Stadium. Just about 27 minutes to go until WrestleMania. We're inside, but our broadcast colleague, Tony Dawson's outside, hanging out with members of the WWE Universe. Tony?
WrestleMania is not only the biggest event of the year for the WWE superstars, divas, and legends, but it's also the biggest night of the year for WWE fans. So many storylines, so many exciting things to look forward to. Let's find out from WWE fans what they're looking forward to most.
We're ready for WrestleMania! Whoa!
Triple H is absolutely going to destroy Brock Lesnar.
The Rock can't see John Cena. Cena is gonna steal this and become the WWE champion.
Let's go, Cena! Cena sucks! Let's go, Cena! Cena sucks!
Finally, WrestleMania has come back! Holy.
Well, thanks, TD. It looks like they're as crazy out there as they are in here.
Well, we asked you guys to have some fun earlier via tout by sending your favorite WrestleMania moment of all time. You guys responded in mass, and with that said, here are your favorite WrestleMania moments via tout.
Hi, my name is Carl. Favorite moment of WrestleMania, WrestleMania 17. Main event, Stone Cold Steve Austin versus The Rock. Simply amazing. Stone Cold, Stone Cold, Stone Cold.
My favorite WrestleMania 28 moment was The Undertaker versus Triple H and Shawn Michaels as special guest referee. End of an era. That was honestly one of my favorite matches of all time. No doubt, bar none.
I would have to say my favorite WrestleMania moment would have to be Shawn Michaels defeating Bret Hart at WrestleMania 12 for the World Heavyweight Championship. I was a huge Shawn Michaels fan at that point.
Hi, my name is Chris, and my favorite WrestleMania moment is when Shawn Michaels came in on the cable for WrestleMania 12.
It's
Excuse me, sir, what was your favorite WrestleMania moment of all time?
WrestleMania 10, ladder match, HBK, Razor Ramon.
Hey, while I got you here, where are you headed?
I'm out of gas.
All right, of course, that's Judah Friedlander from 30 Rock, one of the many celebrities here tonight. Thank you, WWE Universe, for sharing your past favorite memories and moments. Now think of all the memories and moments to come tonight.
And the moments begin in mere minutes. WrestleMania special start time, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. And I tell you what, Matt, it's across so many platforms this year that you can see WrestleMania.
Absolutely. WWE.com, your Xbox Live, which I think is the coolest platform of them all, Samsung Smart TV through the app. How else can we do it? Can we send carrier pigeons? Just be here.
How about actually being at WrestleMania next year? Get your cell phones out right now. Text Mania 30, that's M-A-N-I-A, to 59907 for your chance to be at WrestleMania 30 next year in New Orleans.
Well, WrestleMania 30 may be compromised because lately the fabric of WWE has been tested. But tonight, WWE's first line of defense, Randy Orton, Sheamus, and The Big Show wage war against the Renegade Militia, terrorizing WWE, known simply as The Shield.
Dean Ambrose.
Seth Rollins.
Roman Reigns.
Welcome to the Shield of Justice. Shield of Justice.
Randy Orton. And Sheamus.
The Eye of Justice.
Always watching. Even you, Big Show.
You got one cheap shot.
Big Show knocked out Reigns!
You want some of that?
It'll never happen again.
You don't have to be afraid. Or maybe you do.
Triple powerbomb to the 450-pound Big Show.
The Shield has yet to be beaten.
Nobody can beat us.
Nobody. That ring you're standing in is ours.
And this is the MO for the Shield. The numbers game in their favor tonight. Here comes the Giant! The Shield to become the Hunted! The Shield needs to regroup and retreat!
Randy, Sheamus, Big Show, WrestleMania is upon us, gentlemen. Giant, Viper, Celtic Warrior, if you ask me, those things don't mix. They're too combustible.
There's no love lost between Big Show and Orton and Sheamus.
At WrestleMania, you're gonna fail. You're gonna be stuck in the ring with the Hounds of Justice.
You guys realize that if we don't pull it together, we're gonna be sitting ducks for the Shield.
The strength of our purpose is stronger than any one of you.
United we stand.
You're not too young to die.
You three may think you can play nice together.
Randy and Sheamus are going to be able to trust me about as much as they can trust each other.
The team's going to be lucky if it doesn't implode at WrestleMania.
We're all on the same page, which is really bad news for the Shield.
This is a story about justice, and the final chapter will be written by The Shield at WrestleMania.
This looks like a six-man tag team match they're going to be talking about forever. And Dream, I want to throw this one over to you. Orton, Sheamus, and Big Show, we know that they are forces on their own, but how important is that cohesiveness going to play a part in coming out victorious against the Shield?
Well, let me tell you this. If the Shield is going to be stopped, I haven't seen anyone as of late that can get it done, but I do believe tonight they might get the Viper.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. You're a football guy, JR. There is nothing more dangerous than a team that is clicking on all cylinders, and that is exactly what the Shield is doing at this point in time.
Three of the greatest superstars in WWE history are together tonight, but will there be any dysfunction? I don't know. There will be none with the Shield. I'm going with the Shield tonight. to win their first match at WrestleMania.
Well, I'll tell you what, you can tell from the fans inside the stadium, they are ready for action, so let's get it started. The Intercontinental Championship on the line. We are going down to ringside.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the Intercontinental Championship.
Awesome!
I came to play. There's a price to pay. Tough for you to get down on your knees.
The challenger from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 231 pounds, The Miz!
In his own words, Miz is a future first ballot WWE Hall of Famer. Miz has always considered himself a superstar from his days on MTV to being a former WWE champion, even starring in the motion picture The Marine 3 Homefront. Lacked confidence.
Well, The Miz thrives in the spotlight. Where some shy away from attention, this young man just seems to rise to the occasion. And what a better night than WrestleMania. They're coming from all over the world.
Miz with a tremendous opportunity to once again become Intercontinental Champion, but this time here at WrestleMania.
His opponent from Preston, England, weighing in at 247 pounds, is the Intercontinental Champion, Wade Barrett.
Wade Barrett feels a true champion in WWE should look the part. A champion should have broken noses and busted jaws, according to Wade Barrett.
Well, Wade Barrett has gone on record to say that it wasn't a portrayal, the character that Wade played in Dead Man Down. It was just an extension of Wade's salty, ornery disposition. The native of Preston, UK, is a working-class, bare-knuckle fighter, and he is our Intercontinental Champion.
So a tremendous way to kick off WrestleMania here live on the WrestleMania pre-show. The Intercontinental Championship up for grabs. The champion, Wade Barrett. The challenger, The Miz. Miz, Matt, telling us earlier that he shines the brightest on the stage known as WrestleMania.
Well, again, I think it has a lot to do with Miz's ego. It has to do with Miz's confidence. All eyes on me seems to be Miz's motto.
Miz has called himself mind-blowing, dangerous, awe-inspiring, highly successful roll through here. Barrett shoulders down and pops free at two.
Intercontinental title on the line as The Miz is decked down in New York Jet Green. Let's hope his offense is a little better than that team, huh?
Just about 15 minutes away from WrestleMania, going live on pay-per-view as Wade Barrett. Asserting himself here in this championship match.
Nothing pretty about Wade Barrett's offense. This is a fight.
How awesome is he now, eh?
Hard nose, smashed mouth describes the style of the offense of Wade Barrett.
Now, Wade Barrett's never been handed anything in his life. He's had to work for every single thing. Wade Barrett is a man who earns respect.
Well, Wade Barrett continues this barrage here. Barrett may be leaving WrestleMania with his Intercontinental Championship intact as Barrett continues to assault Miz. Wade Barrett now, first cover of the match by Barrett, and Miz able to slip through it too.
Wade has to be careful not to let his frustrations get the best of him. Wade has to stay on Miz, close the gap.
Now you're talking about a superstar in Wade Barrett who has a degree in marine biology. Wade Barrett is an intellectual superstar. Barrett, I was about to say, won't take a lot of high risks against The Miz. That was pretty risky there, giving Miz a little bit of space, some opening there.
Well, it's some insight into Wade Barrett. Yes, he's educated. Yes, he can be refined, but at the same time, he's got a fighter's face.
And Miz now. Great combination there by The Miz, who flips over into the cover, hooks the outside leg. May have him here, and a kick out by Wade Barrett.
You can see Miz nodding his head with the cadence of the official's count because Miz thrives off of the pageantry. But let me tell you something, Miz, don't get caught.
And Wade Barrett here perhaps looking for Wasteland. Looking to put away The Miz. Miz looking for the skull crushing finale. Wait, Barrett counters.
Yeah, both of the signature maneuvers of these superstars are well scouted. You don't get to WrestleMania on a fluke.
And remember, the Intercontinental Championship on the line here as Wade Barrett snatches Miz out of midair cover, hooks the leg, and Miz pops the shoulder up at two.
Imagine what it feels like to have all of the wind in your body completely leave, your lungs completely collapse. Miz is in a bad way right now.
And Wade Barrett sensing that as well. Wade Barrett now has put away a number of superstars with the Bullhammer Elbow. It's how Barrett became the Intercontinental Champion on New Year's Eve. Can Barrett connect with it here?
This is one of the most graphic maneuvers I've seen in quite some time.
Miz avoids and now Miz looking for the figure four leg lock. The move bestowed on Miz by WWE Hall of Famer, the Nature Boy. And will Wade Barrett tap out?
This is one of the most time-honored submission holds in our industry. This is a sports entertainment heirloom passed down to The Miz by Ric Flair. Wade Barrett is wise.
Wade Barrett able to stay away there, able to make his way to the bottom rope, forcing Miz to break the hold as we close in on 15 minutes and counting until WrestleMania. Barrett now again looking for Wasteland. And this time connects. Barrett into the cover, hooks the outside leg, and retain his championship, and Miz pops up at two. You can hear the WWE Universe here at MetLife Stadium. Nearly 80,000 expected tonight for WrestleMania.
Oh, look at that, a unique takedown by The Miz. Wow, what a unique way to get back into the figure four.
Miz has it locked in once again. Wade Barrett scratching and clawing, trying to make this way. Wade Barrett tapped out. We have a new Intercontinental Champion of WrestleMania!
Here is your winner, and the new Intercontinental Champion, The Miz!
Miz came in with the game plan and stuck with it. The figure four leg lock, and Miz is now a two-time Intercontinental Champion. What a way to get started here at WrestleMania.
History has been made. Miz's mother's in the front row. This is what WrestleMania is all about. Wow.
Miz said earlier that there are two very important matches here at WrestleMania. The very first one, and of course the main event. Miz said he wanted to set the stage here tonight, and he certainly did that.
Well, this has Miz written all over it. Miz's charisma is infectious as he does the leap into the WWE faithful. But Josh, Wade Barrett had the upper hand early. I'm a big Wade Barrett fan. Back and forth it went. Look
Wade
at this.
Barrett would change the momentum there. He calls that the winds of change. Barrett thought he did enough to put away Miz. Not so fast, said the most must-see superstar in all of WWE. Miz would counter there.
I'm a lifelong fan. I've never seen the figure four applied that way. It's a testament to how The Miz has grown. Congratulations to the new Intercontinental Champion.
So congratulations to The Miz. Now a two-time Intercontinental Champion in WWE. Well, that's how you get things started. It was an unpredictable ending. Miz with the figure four leg lock able to put away Wade Barrett.
There's an old saying here in WWE, expect everything. That's what I think we're going to get tonight. Everything.
Weather's starting to play a factor. We're going to send things up now back to Scott Stanford and his panel of experts.
All right, guys, well, we talked about the landscape of the WWE could possibly change tonight. Right off the bat, The Miz, the new Intercontinental Champion. And JR, what a way to ring in WrestleMania with the figure four. I guess you should thank Ric Flair, huh?
We thank Ric Flair for many things over the years, a special week for The Miz to win with the figure four. I love it.
All right, Kofi Kingston, it is time to talk about the main event, The Rock, John Cena. John Cena has said that he is looking to not make the same mistake he did last year, and he's been waiting for this an entire year long. Is this a must-win for John Cena tonight?
This is definitely a must-win for John Cena. Like you said, he has woken up every single morning and thought about the loss that he suffered last year to The Rock at WrestleMania. He would love nothing more than to beat The Rock. Now with the WWE Championship at stake, this is certainly a must-win situation.
You know what, Kofi? I don't know sometimes if it's good to dwell on something for a whole year. Like when great quarterback
throw an interception, they got to forget it right away and go into the next play to try to throw that touchdown pass, if you will. Cena lived with it for a year. It ate at him day in and day out, and he understands the importance of what's going on here tonight. John Cena truly has that eye. I seen it in him, and I know tonight he's going to go all out to become champion again.
All right, JR, I mean, John Cena and The Rock, you could see, have the utmost respect for each other. But once that bell rings, do they throw that respect right out the window?
They better, because one man's going to walk out with the richest prize in all of WWE. And I wonder psychologically how it will affect John Cena. We're going to see it when the bell rings here at WrestleMania for what we hope for about 80,000 fans here at MetLife Stadium. Now, I was involved in recruiting and signing both these guys. They both got a lot of the same DNA. Here's what I'm breaking it down to. If it goes under 30 minutes, The Rock wins. If it goes past 30 minutes, I got John Cena leaving here with a record-setting WWE championship.
Kofi Kingston, what does John Cena have to do tonight to take care of The Rock?
John Cena's got to stay focused. I mean, you saw the match last year, and he made one mistake. He started hot-dogging and showboating, and that cost him the match. He has got to stay focused at all costs.
It's not about the money. It's about the walk down that aisle to that prestigious moment where you step in and you have a blank canvas and you paint your portrait, you paint your win. And I know on John Cena's mind that's there, but The Rock is in the greatest shape of his life. This is gonna be an epic battle.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the WWE Universe locked in and ready to see if The Rock can make it two in a row over John Cena, or if John can get the redemption he's been yearning for over the last year. And this time, the WWE Championship is on the line. Rock, Cena, legacy versus redemption.
Last year at WrestleMania, I told every single person who would listen that I needed to win that match.
Rock bottom! The Rock has beaten John Cena!
And I failed. You don't know what that does to a man, Rock. It makes you feel worthless.
One of these days the sky's gonna break and everything will escape, and I'll know.
You were responsible for my collapse.
One of these days the mountains are gonna fall into the sea, and they'll know.
My once-in-a-lifetime moment stolen. A year of my existence destroyed.
Never fall away.
That match sent my life into a tailspin, both professionally and personally, because I could not get over my obsession with the fact that I failed.
Wanted to face at WrestleMania, and that man is you. No one has your passion, your drive, your fire, your will to win.
Hold me here.
No one except The Rock.
The probable The Rock promised the world that he would win the WWE Championship tonight.
No accolade on this earth that is more deeply ingrained in my blood.
One day soon, I'll hold you like the sun holds the moon.
I have accomplished every single goal in my entire career except for you.
We won't have to be scared.
I mean, this is more than just a match for me. This is a shot at redemption.
John Cena, you ain't getting redemption, Jack. You're getting your ass kicked.
We won't have to be scared.
I have been gifted a second chance to right the biggest wrong of my life.
You think you can beat me? I know I can beat you.
At WrestleMania, my time is now.
At WrestleMania, I will beat you again.
Your own home. It's time to make your house your own. Pick up the phone.